Oftentimes, we in musical theater are made to feel like the bastard stepchildren of fine art music. It's very easy for us to become despondent over what may seem to be forced study of old music by dead composers. Quite frequently, our attitudes are, well, they don't like us, or they don't respect us, so I won't like or respect them. But the fact is, both sides are wrong. Fine art music is the fabric from which we are quilted, and musical theater is the modern opera and oratorio. But some of you doubt that studying opera and choral music will have any impact on your understanding of the genre, so I'll just have to prove that it will. Let's get started by delving into the two ideas of harmonic structure that began in choral music, polyphony and homophony. Polyphony, as we discussed in class, is two or three simultaneous melodic lines that are perceived as independent even though they are related. We call these related melodic lines countermelodies. There are three primary ways to create polyphony. First, canon. Canon has multiple voices that sing the same melody with no changes at different times. Listen to the beginning of this setting of the Ave Maria text by Renaissance composer Josquin des Prez as each of the four SATB voices comes in separately but singing the same melody. The canon's shorter brother is the round, which you may remember from endless renditions of Frère Jacques as a special type of canon in which the last section also fits with the first section, so that the canon can be repeated over and over without stopping. Frère Jacques, Frère Jacques, Frère Jacques. As annoying as this, or the song that never ends, can become, listen to this beautiful moment in Rent, where Jonathan Larson uses the round to great effect.
Will I lose my dignity? Will someone care? Will I wake tomorrow?
Will I wake tomorrow?
this segment of The Call from Adam Gettle's Floyd Collins. This is another example of the phasing I mentioned in class. See how technology, in this case a reverb effect on the microphone, is pushing the genre ahead. The haunting effect both uses of canon and round still have today, just like those Renaissance pieces we've listened to.